Hello, fans. I'm Brad Nessler alongside my colleague Dick Vitale. We're here to call tonight's matchup between the Northeastern Huskies and the College of Charleston Cougars. And here's a look at our star watch comparison. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
We have two excellent players matched at the point guard position. It's going to be interesting to watch how they each try to get their team involved throughout the game.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, here we go. And with the tip, we're underway here in the first half. Looking for a good shot. He unloads, and he missed. He strokes it, and off the mark. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Looking for the pick now.
Hey, a two-man game is great to watch when you have an intelligent dribble.
Gets the rejection. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what you've got in store for us, Aaron.
Well, it's quite obvious that the coaching staff wants their team to slow down the tempo. I can hear him on the sideline talking to his bench players about being patient and running sets. He wants the defense to break down first before settling for a shot. Unless, of course, it's a layup. Guys?
Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent. All of you know that with an additional insight there.
Get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Brantley picked. The layup's good and one, Dick.
Hey, that's good concentration. Taking the ball hard to the hoop, knowing that someone's going to hack you.
And here's a look at the first-year player.
Hey, Brad, a first-year player starting his college career. Really exciting times in front of this young man.
They might have him in some trouble here, Dick.
He's trapped, Brad.
The chanting continues.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Harm and foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket. I like it when the team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
Second one, no good. I want to thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior.
Moving it around the perimeter. They move it into the front court. Out on the left wing. He shoots from the top of the circle. Jumper won't go. They work it around the perimeter. He fouled him. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled him to prevent the easy basket.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You can never have enough leadership on your roster. If you're a coach who's lucky enough to have a couple of upperclassmen, you're definitely at an advantage. Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
A great trap initiated by the defense. Goes up for two. And he can't hit the shot. Gave it up. Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
Off the mark. Drains the shot.
Trying to go inside.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He goes to the line. He makes the first shot. Got him right where they want him, Dick. Great trap. They managed to keep the defender in check.
Hey, trap's giving that kid some fits.
The point guard takes the pass. They'll work it around the arc. Number one is charged with the foul. Third team foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Number four steps to the line for the first time. He hits the first. He can't buy one. Number one with the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. In the lane, scores it. Coach is trying to get the players to think defense now. Now trying to feed the low block for two.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Gave it up.
The athleticism in some of these kids, Brad, I'll tell you, it's incredible.
They're working around the perimeter. There's a slam. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Looking for a good shot. Number two is called for the foul. First personal foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Chance for an easy one. Makes the foul shot. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
He doesn't miss that opportunity either. No problems so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nessler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Working it around the perimeter. Gets that ball in the low block and immediately goes with a shot.
I tell you, did a great job creating a good angle, too. When he goes up and under, he seals off the defensive player.
For the bucket, he doesn't get the hoop. Number four handles the pass. Both teams looking to get things going here. on the outside.
Silly mistake.
Puts up the J. Bust the jumper. Harris is usually described as being one of those powerful inside guys.
He knows how to use his strength, Brad. That's such an important skill. You've got to know how to use it without being called for the foul.
Number one receives the pass. Missed the jumper. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, guys, it's obvious the coaching staff wants the team to slow it down. The tempo is definitely not where they want it. The players have been instructed to run the shot clock offensively and force the opposition to play defense for extended periods of time.
That's, of course, Erin Andrews, our correspondent on the sideline. Jumper, and come up short. Well, whose team tempo went out? That's the question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan. Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Pushing in transition. Too physical. That layup will count for two, plus the harm.
Hey, he sized the defender up and protected the ball going in for the layup. Boy, was that beautiful.
He is going to the line. He hits it. Drop step and oh, good defense.
I got defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step, very slow.
On the left side, lobs it, tries for two. Loose ball, saves it. Great play. Up for two. He couldn't get it to fall. It's good.
Up and inside.
Goes up.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Look at that spacing.
Goes up with it. Bust the J. On the wing. For two. It won't fall. And we're at the 8-minute mark. Bucket, buried it. A great drive to the hoop right there, Dick.
You know, he did a great job putting the ball on the floor and getting to the basket.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. From the corner. Missed it. Johnson receives the ball. The outside. Tries for two. Off target. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Two teams who are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad.
7 minutes left on the game clock. Goes up for two. He gets it to go. working around the perimeter. Six-minute mark. They work the perimeter.
Hey, the defense is doing a great job of denying any shot opportunities off those screens.
Adam, momentary look from three-point land. He gets the layup to go and the foul.
What a hoop. He saw the defender coming and tried to go right through him.
With the free one. Cashed it in. Number one with the foul. Fourth team foul. Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Vic.
Quite just doing his thing. I tell you, Brad, just a great, great performance. I love this kid. He's a PTP-er, baby.
Perimeter. He shoots the jumper. Can't connect. Looking for a good shot. He attempts the jump shot.
I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
If he keeps this up, he may collapse. His teammates must pick it up.
About 5 minutes remaining. Cross court. He pulls up with a jumper. They get it to go. On the dribble, gives it up. He goes up with it. Nails the J. Left on the game clock. Down inside, Northeastern is now in the bonus. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
He goes to the line for the first time. Gets the first shot. Gets two at the charity stripe. They've got him trapped. Great trap. They managed to keep the defender in check.
Great job of containing the man there, Brian.
He may be in some trouble here. Number 22 takes it away.
Pick this pocket, Brad.
Oh, Dick, they're just not taking care of that ball. He tries the jumper. The missed shot. The Cougars in attack mode.
turnaround jumper. Off the mark. On the dribble, gives it up. Three minutes left in the game clock. Puts up the jumper. Missed the jumper. Galloway receives the pass. Takes the jumper. Off the mark.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For two, scores it. Number 40 receives the pass. Gave it up. There's the fake. 2 minutes left on the game clock.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot? There's the trap.
With the J. Nails a sweet jumper. On the left side for the bucket, comes up empty. With the catch, nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
One minute left on the game clock.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Play about ready to resume. Entry pass in the paint. He gets it to fall. Moving it around the perimeter. He puts up the J.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
The Cougars will play up-tempo at one end and in the half court at the other end. Would you agree, Dick?
They try to really get balance in that. They'll get some points with tempo by creating a little fast pace and then slow it down and executing their half-court set, getting high percentage shots.
At the half, the Huskies lead by three. When we get going here today, these will be some of the keys that each team will be paying special attention to all day long.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who's been doing what.
Looks like they're going to go with a full-court man-to-man press, Dick. Now they work it around the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
The small forward takes the pass. Trying to feed inside. Gets the ball and now faces his man down on the low block.
Oh, very aggressive player once he got up in the face-up position in the post.
Harris receives the pass. Looks at a three. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
They work it around the arc. Missed it. On the left side. He shoots the jumper. Nails the jumper. Working around the perimeter. They force the turnover, Dick.
Great charge.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
Cross court. Number 22 picks up the foul. Second team foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He goes to the free throw line. Misses the first shot. Second shot is no good. It's stolen. Now the other way. Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Greens it. The student body has got it going on. They look to be filled with rage and eager for a win.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
Looking for a good shot. He attempts the jump shot. Off the glass and no good. He nails the bucket.
Look at that! That's unbelievable, baby!
Definitely a foul. They get it inside and a chance for a three-point play as they score. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Goes to the line, shooting one. It's good. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Working it around the perimeter. Tries for two. And nice looking jumper in the lane. The dribble, gives it up, goes up for two. can't put it down. Johnson handles the feed. Jumper knocked it down. Game to game, Dick, what might we expect from a half-court oriented team?
Hey, based on what we've seen in their personnel, the half-court style suits them well, Brad. They really rely on spacing and team offensive concepts to score. Longer drawn-out possessions as opposed to quick shots is definitely their style.
They run it up into transition.
They come away with a basket off the break.
On the outside. For two. Off the mark. For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. Jumper won't go. Out on the left wing. He throws it up from downtown. Scorches the net with a J. Gave it up. He pulls up with a jumper. You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win. Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Alley-oop. For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. Shot off. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
For two. That was nice. The man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, its well-executed two-man game is always a treat to watch.
Tries for two. He missed. The small forward takes the pass.
Up and inside.
Balls out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. These guys have really been able to step it up so far, and they're putting together a very good team effort.
I tell you what, they get an A for effort in my book so far, Brad. Sometimes that's the hardest thing to get from your team as a coach. When you have everyone on your team working together and playing hard, great things work out. Look at that spacing.
Tries the three. And yet another missed field goal attempt, Dick.
I tell you, horrific, awful, terrible, poor, appalling. I'm absolutely embarrassed, Brad.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. This is college basketball at its best, Dick.
Wow, the energy in here is electrifying.
On the low block, goes up, knocks it down. The outside. He takes the fadeaway. Nails the fadeaway. They work it around the perimeter.
shoots from outside.
They get it to go.
They work the perimeter.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
It is pretty similar.
Wow. Didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Goes up for two. He hits the shot. A little two-man action. For two, off the glass and no good. Around 8 minutes remaining. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For the bucket, too strong. Looking for a good shot. Let's watch the move as he works his man and not a fadeaway jumper. Johnson receives the ball. He goes up with it. Scores it. Number 22 gets the ball. He tries the jumper and come up short. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Tries for two. Gave it up. He puts up the J. Busts the jumper. Got it down the low block. He shoots the jumper. Missed the jumper. On the left side.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps. About 6 minutes remaining. Harris handles the pass. Goes up for two. No good. Dribble, gives it up. Green is seemingly at an emotional low point at this moment, Dick.
Brad, I see a young man who's struggling at both ends of the court.
Moving it around the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner. Bust the J. They work it around the perimeter. We're at the 5 minute mark. Takes the jumper. Off the mark. Johnson handles the feed.
work it around the arc.
We approach 10 seconds now on the shot clock.
He takes the shot from the baseline. The deuce. It's good.
Four minutes left on the game clock.
Looking for a good shot.
Goes up.
He's taking his team out of the game plan with these shots, Dick.
Yeah, and even if you were hitting them, Brad, they're still bad shots.
He shoots from downtown. Gets the J to fall. Dumps it in. He goes up with a jumper. He misses the J.
Working it around the perimeter. We're at the 3-minute mark. And now the fadeaway jumper. While the horrific shooting continues.
These guys have been rock bottom. Their confidence at the moment couldn't be any lower.
On the outside.
He tries the jumper. Nails a sweet jumper.
Johnson handles the feed.
Goes up for two. He couldn't get it to fall.
Number four takes the pass.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Count that as a personal foul.
Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
Got it!
He may be in some trouble here. Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
What a great defensive trap there.
About 2 minutes remaining. Goes right through the trap.
That trap didn't scare him, Brian. Inside.
He throws it up from downtown. He drains the jumper.
Look at that spacing.
For the bucket. Lays it up.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Ten seconds. Misses a shot from in close. On the left side. Dumps it in. Number one is charged with the foul. Fourth team foul. Couple of free ones. Foul shot is not good. Hits his second. 3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard the arc.
The shooting guard with the ball.
tries for two. For two, with a layup. Timeout on the floor. Aaron Andrews, what do you got for us, EA?
As you guys know, free throw shooting becomes very important down the stretch. The coaching staff is aware of this, and we'll be talking about this in the timeout. It'll be up to the players to knock them down.
Having paced those sidelines as a head coach before, Dick, what were some of the things that you made sure happened during timeouts?
I've said it before, but controlling the adrenaline levels was big for me. I never want my players to be too overexcited for any length of time. I think it takes away from the player's ability to perform.
We'll get back to the action here after the timeout. It's a five-point ball game.
That's not a lot of points to be down with this much time, Brad.
Dumps it in with the fadeaway. Gets the fade to fall. On the outside. Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. Shot clock is dead. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Foul, and that stops the clock again. To the charity stripe. He makes the front end of the one and one. Second one, good.
You don't need the desperation three. It's a two-possession game.
And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. They're working around the perimeter. He puts up the tray. And he missed. Number one commits his last personal. One plus one, if it's good. He makes the front end of the one and one. Gets his second. He's fine to charge.
Great court savvy by the youngster.
And And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Second one is no good. Pushes it up. He puts it up at the horn. He misses the jumper. Charleston loses in a well-fought match.
They'll be disappointed to come up short to such an evenly matched team.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.